Education Minister Jan Tinetti joins us this morning. Minister, you must be disappointed that it's come to this.
Oh, morena, yes, I am very disappointed that it's come to this, but really, really strongly focused on getting a solution here very quickly.
Are the teachers being unreasonable?
Look, we know that it's been a really tough time for teachers over the last couple of years. It's like it has been for everybody, but my heart specifically goes out to our teachers and what they've had to do to get our young people through COVID. So we know that conditions are tough at the moment. I know this better than anyone. This was my life's work. I've stood where they're standing today as well in the past. So I know their dedication to their young people and I support them in the work that they're doing. I just want to get to a resolution quickly.
Okay, but are they being unreasonable? You've just said really nice things about them, but you haven't given them what they want.
I think that it's more than just remuneration. I think that the offer that has been on the table at the moment has been a reasonable offer. But at the same time, there are other issues, and that's what we need to really look into and how can we support them to be able to do the best job that they can.
Is one of the issues, and I'm just floating this with you, and I don't know if this is one of the issues, but Stuff is reporting some of the specific asks that are on the table, and one of them is some of these pay increases, which when you look back don't seem unreasonable. We have had, as you point out, a cost of living increase, there's been inflation, but the union seems to be asking, at least for primary school teachers, seems to be asking for an increase into the future when we look like we might be facing a recession. So are some of the things on the table going to be non-negotiable for you, or are you still committed to seeing if you can make all of their asks happen?
Look, there's not much that I can talk about in this space because that would breach good faith bargaining. But what I can tell you is that my officials work very closely with the union. They come back and they talk with me, and then I talk with my colleagues. Everything is still on the table. That's good faith bargaining, so I don't want to breach that at this stage.
Why wasn't there an offer presented at that last meeting on Tuesday?
So I know that we came very close. I know that a lot of progress was made in that time.
What does that mean? What does close mean? Because the NZEI said there was no formal offer. Close
again,
would be an offer, right, that you can take away and say, OK, we'll sign it or not.
Again, Anna, I'm in a really hard place here because it would breach that good faith bargaining position. There's only limited things that I can say and will say at this point in time. What I can say is that progress was made, and I know that's frustrating for people, but I'm feeling really confident about the progress that was made.
Are you feeling as confident about the progress with secondary teachers? That meeting tomorrow is scheduled with the ERA because talks have effectively broken down.
Well, we'll see where we are tomorrow after the end of tomorrow. What I can tell you is that I've met with PPTA this week personally. I met with NZEI at the end of last week. I'm feeling in a good place for both unions.
But it's not a good sign if you're having to go to mediation with one of those unions.
I don't know. Is that not a good sign? That's why we have those processes in place, so that we can actually be really clear. We've got good processes, industrial processes in this country. That is one of those processes. I don't see that as necessarily a bad thing.
What do you hope for then? Obviously, everyone wants to avoid another strike, but what's a reasonable hope that in the next week, what sort of progress would you be looking at making? Are we going to see this is only one strike and a one-off?
That is my hope. That is what I am working really hard towards. I know that this is really disruptive for our young people and disruptive for our families as well. But I stand strongly with the teachers and their ability to be able to demonstrate how important they are, and the work that they do is really important. So I'm working really hard at my end. I know they're working really hard at this too. It's not just about us hoping that there's only one strike. They are hoping the same as well.
Without going into those details that you cannot talk about, is anyone moving? Is there any movement from either side on this, or is this a negotiation where you're slowly coming closer towards what they want?
Look, I've been involved in negotiations for years. In fact, I used to lead the primary principals negotiations back in my time, and I can tell you that there's movement.
On both sides?
Yes.
Well, all the best, Minister Tinetti, for getting both sides to meet in the middle, hopefully within the next week. Education Minister Jan Tinetti joining us from Wellington this morning. Thanks for your time.